not going to be an easy day. The riders will leave Unley and they'll go up to the Southern Expressway. Now, the Southern Expressway, it's quite easy in a car, but on the bike, it's quite difficult. And if there's a bit of a southerly prevailing, it could make it a tough work for the riders. Now, after they reach the expressway, they'll turn off and head to Kangarilla for the first sprint of the day. There'll be valuable bonus points to be earned and seconds to be earned in Kangarilla. And from there, they'll go off to Wickham's Hill. It's not an easy climb. It's about 3 or 4 kilometres. The guys will have to be pedalling in a small chain ring. It is a good opportunity to place an attack there. Wickham's Hill could be long enough to break the peloton up into smaller pieces. It's a sort of stage where it's very hard to predict who can win. Will it be a breakaway or will it be a bunch sprint? One thing for sure, it's going to be difficult. Tip of the day, definitely I would say Alan Davis. But we can't forget our own Team UniSA riders, and I think somebody like Timothy Rowe might be up there towards the finish. All in all, I would say the best spot for the spectators to view would be at the finish. Sure, Wickham's Hill is not a bad climb to view the riders. I would say if you could see the riders at the start at Unley, possibly then the expressway and head off to the finish in Stirling and try and find a good spot. So after having a good look at the course today, getting pretty hungry. It's a pretty undulating hilly day. I'm going to meet Jeff now, and Jeff's got some food prepared for me. I look forward to lunch. I've burnt a few calories, so I need to replace them now.
So Pat, you know, the riders have to take in a lot of food and fluid for, you know, being out on the road for so long. So give me an idea as to the, you know, how much food really is it that they need to take in during a day?
Yeah, a typical Santos Tour Down Under stage would last between 3.5-4 hours. The guys are racing flat out, obviously, so their heart rates are between 160 and 190 beats a minute, which means they'll be burning a lot of calories. Typical rider, typical 75 kilogram rider would probably burn around 5,000 calories and probably, depending on the temperature of the day, drink between 3 and 5 litres of fluids.
So 5,000 calories.
That's right.
5,000 calories. Well, that's equivalent to 12 burgers.
Yeah, if you like hamburgers, then 12 burgers will get you through the day. Not sure about the nutritional value of the hamburger, but yeah, 12 hamburgers will easily burn that up.
So that's also the equivalent of 263 olives.
Well, if you like olives, and we are in Stirling and it is a local producer, but to eat 263 olives, I don't think the riders will be eating 263 olives.
Or 8 French sticks.
Yeah, well, I'm sure the French riders love the French sticks, and if you want to have 8 of those to get through the stage, well, then that's a possibility, of course.
And it's the equivalent to about 6.5 bottles of wine.
Yeah, well, Jeff, I wouldn't recommend the rider drink wine during a stage, but there's enough calories in the wine to carry you through. Okay, Jeff, now that we've refueled and carbo loaded, we're ready for our 140 kilometre stage. So, ready or not, let's go and let's burn some calories.